Let's analyze mass variation cases. Here we can write 1 hour mass of a system. You can also write mass of a system or bodies changes with time during motion. Such cases can be handled by concept of impulse and conservation of momentum. You should always keep in mind that whenever masses are varying for a system or a single body also, we can say whenever mass variation is there, we'll always handle such type of situation by impulse and momentum conservation. In general, there are two cases which can be formed. Two cases can be there. Case one would be the situation when external force is absent. So, we can state if external force is absent, total momentum of system will remain conserved. And another case is the one when external force is present. And obviously, if external force is present, it will impart momentum to the system. So, its overall momentum will either increase or decrease. Let's discuss both of these cases step by step with the various different kind of examples how we can apply in cases of mass variation. So, let's first discuss the case when external force is not present. So, we can simply state if mass is continuously varying, we'll write down a hint for solving such a problem of mass variation when external force is not present. We can state in such cases, we use conservation of momentum at an intermediate time of motion from t to t plus dt. So, if mass of a body is varying in a very short duration dt, its mass will obviously change by infinitesimally. So, in a small duration t to t plus dt, we conserve overall momentum of the system. To understand the concept, we take up an example of rocket propulsion. We all know that the situation of rocket propulsion is based on conservation of momentum. In a given rocket, its gases, fuels are ejected from the backside due to which the rocket experiences a thrust in forward direction and it will accelerate. And it is because of conservation of momentum. Let us consider at a general time t, rocket is of mass m. It is moving at a speed v and its gases are ejected at a rate of r kilogram per second. Let it be the ejection rate of gases. And we are also given that gases are ejected with a speed u. And in general cases of mass variation, always the speed is given relative to rocket. Or more precisely, we should write the object from which the mass is ejecting out, its speed is given with respect to the mass. In this situation, say if we wish to analyze the velocity of rocket at a time t, if the rocket was started from rest. So, in this situation, for a general case, we can state at a general time t, its mass is m and speed is v. If we analyze its situation at a time t equals to t plus dt, then in this situation, we can say as rocket was ejecting gases at a rate of r kilogram per second, in a time dt, a small lump of gases or fuel will be ejected out which can be written as of mass dm, which is equals to r dt. Because r kg per second is the ejection rate. So, in a time dt, the amount of fuel or gases which is ejected out will be r dt. As the rocket was moving with the speed v, its speed will increase from v to v plus dv. And as this lump of gases is ejected from the moving rocket, so its velocity can be written as u minus v plus dv, because it was ejected from a moving rocket. So this gas would also be having the velocity v plus dv in forward direction, and from it it is ejected at a speed u. So its net velocity with respect to ground, or in ground reference frame, we can state its velocity will be given by this. Now in this situation, we can see that from time t to t plus dt, no external force is acting on it. So we can say by conservation of momentum, in this situation we can write, at time t and time t plus dt, if we conserve the momentum, we can state at time t its momentum was mv. This must be equal to the momentum at time t plus dt. So here we talk about the rocket earlier, its mass was m. And after ejection of this lump of gases, its mass would be m minus dm. So its momentum can be written as m minus dm into v plus dv. And the momentum of this lump of gases, which is in opposite direction, so we can write it negative of dm into u minus v minus dv. So now, if we just simplify this expression, we'll see it is mv is equals to mv minus dmv plus mdv. We can neglect the product of dm into dv, because two elemental quantities product can be considered to be negligible. Here it is minus dmu plus dmv. Again, the product of two elemental quantities can be neglected. Here mv gets cancelled out, and this dmv also gets cancelled out. So this will give us mdv is equals to dmu. I've just taken one term on the other side of equality. Now, in this expression, I can see if I divide both sides with the term dt, you can see dv by dt we can write as acceleration of the rocket. So it is ma is equals to dm by dt is the rate at which the mass is decreasing, that is rate of ejection of gases or fuel, which can be written as ru. Now here ma is the instantaneous mass multiplied with the acceleration of rocket, which can be considered as net force acting on rocket. However, we can see that in this situation, when rocket is ejecting gases, in this situation gases are ejected at a rate of r kg per second, and the rocket is accelerating forward. Here as no external forces acting on the rocket, but with expression we can see the net force acting on rocket is ru. Here we can see that this force is basically due to continuous ejection of gases. So we can consider that due to ejection of gases, rocket experiences a thrust in forward direction, and the magnitude of this thrust can be given as ru. So always keep this expression in your mind, that the net thrust due to ejection of gases from a rocket or from any moving object through which if its mass is ejected out in the direction opposite to the ejection of mass, the body experiences a thrust, which is given as the product of rate of ejection of mass and the relative speed at which the mass is being ejected from the body. So using this, we can analyze the velocity, we can analyze the mass, or any other parameter which is asked in different type of questions, we can analyze by using this process. We'll see it in some different examples also. Now let's discuss the second case, when external force is present on the system from which mass is changing. Now, as we have studied, if external is absent, we use simply conservation of momentum at time t and t plus dt during the motion. Similarly, here we can say, when F external is present, in such cases, we use impulse momentum equation for the motion of body at an intermediate time t and t plus dt. We write impulse momentum equation at an intermediate time of motion t and t plus dt. Let's analyze an example based on the same phenomena, like the example is related to a movable tank. Say this is a floor on which say we are having a movable tank which is filled with the water, and the total mass of tank and its contents is m at t equal to 0. And at the initial moment of time, we have just created a hole at the back side of the tank due to which water is starting ejecting out. And say water is coming out at a rate of r kilogram per second at a speed u which is relative to tank. Simultaneously, an external force F is applied onto the tank due to which the tank is moving forward. Now, in this situation, we are required to find, say, the velocity of tank as a function of time. The question is, find velocity of tank as time function in the given situation. Now, here we can see that with time, the mass of tank will continuously decrease. So, at any time t equals to t, we just analyze the situation of the tank. Still, it will be experiencing the force F. By this time, its mass would have been decreased to m minus rt, because if it is ejecting liquid at a rate of r kg per second, then after time t, its liquid or contents will be of mass m minus rt. Still, liquid is ejecting out, and the speed it would have gained till this time is say v. And if we further analyze it at time t plus dt, then at time t plus dt, we can state k in this situation, further its mass will decrease to small m minus dm. Still the force is acting, and say its speed increases to v plus dv, and it will eject a small elemental mass of the liquid which is being ejecting out, and the speed of this mass, which is u relative to tank, but tank is moving at a speed v plus dv. The same concept we have studied at the time of rocket propulsion also. So the speed of this can be written as u minus v minus dv. Now, if we write impulse momentum equation at time t and t plus dt, because external force is present, so overall momentum will not remain conserved. So we can write, here we write impulse momentum equation for tank. In this situation, you can see that initial momentum of the tank can be written as mv at time t, and as the force F is acting onto it in the duration from t to t plus dt, we can see that the force has imparted a momentum to it, that is F dt. And this will be equal to the final momentum of the tank, which can be written as m minus dm into v plus dv. And as this elemental mass dm, which is going back, can be written as minus dm into u minus v minus dv. Now, if we just simplify the expression, you can see we'll be having mv plus f dt is equals to mv minus dmv plus mdv. Again, I'll ignore the product of two elemental quantities. and here it is minus dmu plus dmv. Again, the product of elemental quantities is neglected. Here mv gets cancelled out and we can see here dmv also gets cancelled out. So, we'll be having f dt is equals to mdv minus dmu. In this expression, we can substitute the values of m and dm. As we know that at a general time t, the mass of tank can be written as m minus rt and dm, the elemental mass, can be written as r dt because r is the rate of ejection. So, if we substitute, we can see we'll be getting f dt is equals to m minus rt into dv minus ru dt. Now, this term I can take on left hand side of equality. So, this will be f plus ru into dt is equals to m minus rt into dv. As we are required to find the velocity of tank after time t, so I can rearrange the expression as dv is equals to f plus ru into dt upon m minus rt. This is the way how we can write it. Now, if we integrate this expression from t equals to 0 to t and speed can be integrated from 0 to v, this will give us v is equals to f plus ru and 1 by m minus rt can be integrated as minus 1 by r ln of m minus rt from 0 to t. And if I substitute the limits in this expression, I'll get v is equals to f plus ru upon r into ln of m upon m minus rt. This will be the answer to this question. And with this example, we also understood it well. If external force is present, how we handle the situation. However, there is a direct way to handle this problem also. Let's see an alternative way. In this alternative method, we can see that if we talk about the tank, which is filled with the liquid of mass m, including the mass of tank. In this situation, an external force F was acting on it. And due to an opening at the back, if liquid is coming out at a constant rate of r kilogram per second with a speed u relative to tank, then in this situation we can state the concept which we have just studied at the time of rocket propulsion, that whenever from a body some mass is ejected at a constant rate with a relative speed u, it exerts an opposite thrust onto the body that is given as ru. So, if we just draw the free body diagram of this tank, we can state the net force acting on tank would be F plus RU, where RU is the force or thrust acting on this particular tank due to the ejection of liquid. Now, in this situation, if this is the net force acting on it and it was moving at a speed V, so we can write F plus RU is equals to M into dV by dt, that is the equation of motion of this tank. So, from here we can directly write dv is equals to dt upon small m. Small m can again be written as the mass at time t, which is m minus rt. This dt upon m minus rt into f plus ru. Now, you can see this is exactly the same expression which we have deduced in the previous slide by using impulse momentum equation at time t and t plus dt. Now, if you integrate it for the limits from 0 to t and 0 to v, you will get the speed as a function of time. The same answer you are going to get.